How y'all doing today? Are you having a good day? I hope you're having a good day. I just realized I still have my hat on backwards. I wear a hat backwards a lot of the time, but I don't know if I've done it in a video. Today, I want to discuss purchase decisions, gear, all this sweet gear that makes you feel all warm and fuzzy inside. No, really, it actually makes you feel warm and fuzzy inside because it's hot as shit. Each one of these pieces of outboard gear puts off as much heat as, it's just about as much heat as a candle. And so the more gear you have, the better HVAC you have, and that's a real problem. So those of you that have been on the channel before, you know that I look at these things super zoomed out, and I try to look at the angles in which it makes it easier for you to have a career. This is how I've gotten where I am within my music career. And these are some of the things that have been important in terms of me getting where I am. Purchase decisions was a big part of that, honestly. Choosing the right pieces of gear was super important for me. It helps me not waste money and helps me get to the goals that I want and helps me get to a better end result faster with the least amount of money spent. And it's not about how much you have or how little you have. It's about being smart with what it is that you do have. And so today we're gonna go over just that. This video should apply to most people within music, whether you're an artist or a singer-songwriter or you're a producer or a mix engineer. The ideas here are all the same, and you can take these same concepts and these same principles and apply it to everything, even though we are actually gonna talk about some specific pieces of gear. First thing that you gotta do is figure out what's the most important physical piece of gear or physical thing that is holding you back. What's holding you back more than any other physical thing? Not talking about skills and not talking about, you know, mental or time or anything else like that. What's the most physical thing holding you back? Now, right out of the gate, a lot of people are gonna be like, oh, I need a better microphone, or I need a compressor or whatever. And that is very important. All that stuff is very important, and I definitely want to talk about that. If you're in the studio world like I am, and you're a producer or a mix engineer, I would argue that acoustic treatment is the single most important thing in terms of you making good quality music, and that is probably what's holding you back more than anything else. If you've ever mixed in your studio and everything sounds awesome, and then you take it out to your car and it kind of sounds like crap in your car, chances are it's because your room is not treated very well, and acoustic treatment will make all of your music translate better because you can more accurately hear what it is that's happening within your music. Now, if you're an artist or a singer-songwriter, I mean, it might be something like the guitar that you have doesn't stay in tune very well, or, you know, some of the gear is unreliable. Maybe your amp kind of cuts out once in a while, or this can go in many different ways, but I think the important thing is that you are real enough with yourself to identify the thing that's holding you back the most. And then that becomes your next purchase. This is how I've chosen nearly every piece of gear in this room, all the gear that you just saw. It all was specifically chosen to solve a problem for me. It was an area that I was feeling held back in. Now, obviously, you can't go buy a whole bunch of stuff all at once unless you win the lottery, or maybe you're rich. Maybe you can go buy a whole bunch of stuff at once. I cannot. And so what I do, and I still do this to this day, even with all of this gear, I still figure out what is the thing that's holding me back the most. What is the thing that can most drastically improve what it is that I do? And then that becomes my next purchase. So monitors and acoustic treatment is a big one. We already talked about that. The next thing for me was compression. Things have come a long ways since I had this conversation with myself, but compression was one of the things that I felt like plugins just didn't do very well. And if I'm being completely honest, I think compression is still the downfall of plugins. I'm fine with most EQs. Compression is a different thing to me. This is my personal opinion and what I feel about the subject. So what I do then, what I did, is then I chose the most important pieces that would make the biggest impact on what it is that I do. And so the first thing was master bus compression. Since all of your music, everything for every song goes through your master bus, and I use master bus compression, some of you may not, but since I do use master bus compression, that was a thing where I was like, if I get my master bus compressor analog, it would make a drastic difference, and it would make the biggest impact on what it is that I did. And so I got a Charter Oak SCL1, which a buddy of mine now has. Fantastic compressor, super transparent, love the way that it sounds. It ended up not having enough attitude for me, ended up wanting something more aggressive. And then the next step was, well, let's pass this through some analog color. And so I had a Vintec 273, a two-channel mic preamp. And so then I would come out of Pro Tools on my mix bus, and I would go through that Vintec, and then in from the Vintec into the Charter Oak. And then that gave me another level of impact. That was the biggest change that I could make within my mixes with the fewest pieces of gear. And so hopefully this is kind of making sense where I'm going with this. And then after that, I was like, what's the next thing I struggle the most with? And it ended up being drum bus compression. For me, I just couldn't get my drum bus to sound the way that I wanted it to with plugins only. And so I ended up going with the TubeTech LCA-2B that you saw on the rack there. And that solved so many issues for me because that's such a wonderful sounding compressor. It's so great on the drum bus, and I run it in parallel on my drum bus still to this day. And so then that again made the next most important impact for what it is that I was doing. And then at the same time, I really needed a better compressor to track vocals with. I had like a Focusrite channel strip at the time. Getting that compressor then let me have a really, really great compressor to track vocals through. And still to this day, that TubeTech LCA-2B that's my favorite vocal compressor of all time. And I've worked in all the big studios and I've used all the greatest compressors and all the industry standards. And I still think that TubeTech is the best. In terms of instruments, the guitars were huge for me, the guitars and the amps. It was really important for me to have high quality stuff that stayed in tune really well and that intonated flawlessly up and down the neck. And so that led me down this path of being a real kind of snobby guitarists, because I needed flawless instruments, not a plug. But that's one of the reasons why I've landed on these iconic guitars that you saw in that B-roll. Is, man, they're fantastic. I've played Paul Reed Smiths, I've played Sirs, and I'm not trying to discuss what guitars are better or worse, but I play iconic guitars on pretty much everything, and I can't say enough good things about them. They fix a problem for me. On top of being beautiful, inspiring instruments, they solve the issue of having intonation problems or tuning problems. They're flawless, and that's what I look for when I'm choosing gear to buy. Microphones, vocal microphones is another big thing. I at one time just had one decent vocal mic. It was a Neumann M147, I believe, was my first like real serious condenser microphone, and it was fine. And what was interesting is it sounded fantastic on some singers. And then other singers, I used to fight and I used to struggle to get it to sound good. And I didn't know at the time, hopefully this will help some of you, but what I now know is that different microphones work better with different singers. And so the move is to have a couple different microphones, in my opinion, that cover a wide range of singers. And so what I did was that Neumann was not working on certain singers. And so I was like, well, what singers is it not working on? And what it ended up being is anyone with a higher voice, anything scratchier, anything more nasally, that microphone just didn't sound that great. And so, but it sounded fantastic on other people. So then what that let me know is that I need to find a microphone that complements the higher singers, female singers, higher, scratchier male voices, nasally voices. And so then I chose a different microphone to handle that stuff. And so this circle that you just keep running, and this does a couple things. One, you get to the finish line faster. You get to the place where you can make really great products, really great sounding music faster, which helps you get to the place where you can have a successful career faster. Now, if you're struggling to get your vocals to sound great, it is also possible that maybe you need some vocal lessons. I think part of this whole thing is being really honest with yourself and really self-analytical enough to understand where the gear needs to happen to make the difference, or maybe it's your skill set. And so identifying, you know, being able to separate those two things out and then also know what your weakest link is gear-wise, super important. Most important things in my room, the things that help me out the most, acoustic treatments, number one. These Oratone 5Cs and these NS10s are number two. I like my Opals, don't get me wrong, but I really need these two speakers to do what it is that I do. After that, mic preamps. Love my Coil Audios, love my Cappies. It's really important. Good microphones is super important. The microphones that I have, the ones that I listed earlier, my iconic guitars, and my Friedman and my Third Power amps. Those are very important to me. My compressors, my mix bus compressor is a Serpent SB4001. Gonna do a video on it, a standalone video on it pretty soon, I think. And then a bunch of Cappy compressors and the tube tech that I already talked about. So at this point, what's interesting is at this point, I've hand chosen all these pieces of gear to solve a very specific problem. And now all of these pieces of gear are very important to me to be able to do what it is that I do as well as I do it. So I hope that helps some of you decide what piece of gear to buy next. But more importantly, I hope that it helps you get to the point where you're making a living off of this music thing faster and become more successful. Because really, if you look at everything super zoomed out like this and this is how you approach everything, trying to get to the finish line of making a career out of music and paying your bills with music, when you look at it that way, it's a lot easier to get there. Hope that helps. Hit me up on Instagram at Colt Caparoon. Hit my website up, ColtCaparoon.com. If you're on Facebook and it's your thing, hit me up there. I would love it if you would give me a thumbs up on this video and hit the subscribe tab and the little bell icon next to the subscribe tab. And drop me a comment. Let me know what your favorite piece of gear is or whatever you feel like commenting. Your guys' interaction and your comments, your likes, your thumbs up, and your comments is part of what makes these videos do well or not do well. So the more interaction I get from you guys, the better the videos do, and it means the world to me. I can't thank you guys enough for the help and for all the interaction. You guys are the best. All right, see you in the next one. Peace.